Hello. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to provide configuration to a Node-RED application in a container. But before we start, let's go through the prerequisites, which follow on from the previous tutorials. So you need to have an up-to-date version of Windows, Mac OS, or Linux. You need to have Docker version 19.03 or later. You need to have an active Docker ID and a GitHub account. And you need to have the Git tooling installed on your system. You also should have completed the previous tutorials integrating source control with Node-RED and packaging a Node-RED application in a container. As the instructions in this tutorial expect you to have the template project forked to your GitHub account and cloned as a Node-RED project. So when you create a container, you don't want to embed all the configuration within the container. If you connect to external services, you don't want to capture that configuration within your Node-RED flow in the container. And the 12-factor config rule required that config is stored in the environment. In a modern developer environment, a container is built once and then deployed to multiple different environments as it goes through the various test and quality control processes before it gets into production. And at each environment, the cloud management system will provide the appropriate configuration for the environment. In Node-RED, you normally capture configuration in the configuration properties of a node. And that then embeds the configuration within the container. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at how you can provide environment variables to the container and replace the static configuration in the node config with environment variables. We're using Docker, and we'll also show you how you can then pass in environment variables to a Docker container. And there are two ways of doing that. You can use the lowercase e command line option to set a variable either directly in the command line or taking it from your local environment variables. And the other option is using the env file option where you pass in a file containing environment variable definitions. And we'll use both mechanisms in the tutorial. So moving on to step one, first make sure that you stop any containers that you have running, any Node-RED containers you have running from the previous tutorials. And then you want to start a Docker container, but this time we're going to pass in an environment variable called www, and we're going to set the value to 123. So we'll pass the minus e option on the command line. When the container is running, open up the browser and the Node-RED editor, and you're going to modify the inject payload to inject the value of the environment variable. So if you use a little drop down, you'll see at the bottom there is an environment variable option. So select that and then set the correct variable, which is www. If you then deploy that and then inject the message, you'll see that the output is 123, which is the value we passed in for that environment variable. Now go and modify the inject node again, and this time select a string property to inject for the payload. And you're going to set the value to dollar open curly brackets and then www and then close curly brackets. So this is a special syntax which is replaced as a flow is loaded with environment variable values if they exist. If you deploy this change and then test it out again, you'll see that like the previous example, we get the value 123. So we've replaced the www string with the value of the environment variable. So moving on to step two, we're now going to set up a slightly more advanced option where we're going to run a local MQTT broker. And to do this, I've provided you a repository, a GitHub repository, with all the broker configuration and the SSL certificates all pre-prepared. So if you go and clone the GitHub repository, I suggest you do it in your home directory because that's where the examples show. And then we need to configure Docker to allow containers to communicate. By default, when you deploy a container, it can't access any other container running within Docker. But what we can do is we can create a user-defined network bridge, and all containers that share the same network will be able to communicate. And what's more, you will get automatic name resolution using the name parameter when you started a container. So we're going to create a network, and then we're going to start the broker. Again, we're going to use the pre-prepared Docker container. And what we need to do is we need to map a directory from that cloned Git repo into the container so the Mosquito server can access the configuration and the certificates. Remembering to add the container to the newly created network, and we have to name it MQTT Broker. The certificates provided require the server hostname is MQTT Broker. So once you've got your broker running, you can optionally go and add additional users. So the Docker exec command allows you to run a command within a running container. So I've shown you how to do that. And then you can also look at the logs. So Docker logs, if you do the -F, the follow option, will allow you to have live access to the logs as they're produced. If you do that, you can then use the Control C key combination to exit the logs. In step three, we're going to connect to the running MQTT broker. So again, we're going to stop Node-RED, and we're going to remove the container because now we want to run it again, but this time we need to pass in that same Git repo because now Node-RED needs to access the public certificate for the MQTT broker. And we also need to make sure that the Node-RED container is running on the same network so it can access the MQTT container. So start Node-RED with the additional command line options. And then, as we did in a previous tutorial, use the menu, which is next to the deploy button, to import a flow and cut and paste the flow from the instructions. That will add some additional nodes to your flow, and you'll see there are two instances of the MQTT node. Now, MQTT nodes both share the same server configuration. So if you open either of the nodes, and then next to the server property, click the pencil icon to open the server configuration. When you import a flow, you don't import the credentials. They're not exported when you export a flow. So if you click to the security option, and then we need to add the username and password, which are Mosquito and password, replacing the O with the number 0. And then if you just go back to the connection tab and we just look at the configuration. So you see we've got the server hostname and the port. So we're using a secured TLS SSL connection to the broker. You've then got the enable security section. And again, you've got a pencil icon where you can go in and edit the SSL configuration. So we're going to use keys and certificates from the local files because we've mapped the directory containing the certificate into the Node-RED file system. And we're just going to set the path to where the public certificate for the server is. And then because the certificate is expecting the name MQTT broker, which is what we've set, we can also verify the server certificate. So that will check that the host name matches what is in the certificate. We also set the host name within the server name here in the configuration. So if you hit the update and done button to get out of all of the configuration and then deploy the flow, you should see the two MQTT nodes connect to the broker. And what the sample does is every 10 seconds, it injects the current time and then sends it to the MQTT broker. The second line of the flow simply subscribes to the same topic. So it's going to receive all the messages sent from the first node, and it then just puts them onto the debug console. If you notice, the debug node has been configured also to output to the system console, which is what the additional extra symbol is. And that means we can now use the docker logs command to look at the output of that debug node in the container logs. So now that we're in a situation where we've got the nodes working, but we have captured all of the configuration within the config, and that's not what we want to do. So what we're going to do in step 4 is remove all of that static configuration. So again, open up the server configuration, and this time we're going to change all of the static configuration to use environment variables. So if you follow the instructions and set the correct environment variables on each of the configuration fields, so the MQTT server hostname, the port and the client ID, on the connections tab. On the security tab, you're going to use the MQTT user and MQTT PWD. Now the password, you're not going to be able to see this because it's a password field, so you just get the dots entered. But don't worry, I'll show you how you can go and check that that has the right value, so just type it in. And then back into the TLS configuration editor, you're going to set the certificate file name and also the server name again. So press update when you've made all the changes and then deploy the flow. If you now go and open up the flow file that's in your NRData projects directory, you'll be able to see all of the replacements. And then in the first tutorial, I asked you not to encrypt the credentials file, and you can now go and open the flow credential file, and here you can see that we've got the environment variable names. If you encrypt the credentials file, it all still works, but you've got no way of then checking that you've entered the correct environment variable names into those fields. And now there is actually no need to encrypt that credentials file because it doesn't contain any sensitive data. So it's up to you in the future whether you want to use that encryption. Obviously, if you do have any sensitive data, you would have to encrypt it. But if you're replacing all the config with environment variables, then there's nothing sensitive in that file, so you don't need to encrypt it. Moving on to step 5, we now need to provide the environment variables to Node-RED container. And as there are quite a few environment variables, we're not going to set them all on the command line. Instead, you're going to create a new file. Now this has to be in the project directory. Go into that directory and then create a new file called env.list, and then add all of the environment variables and their values into that file. And again, it's shown in the instruction file. And now we need to restart our Node-RED container, but this time we're going to pass in that environment variable list file. Use the command as shown. We're going to pass in the environment variables. We're going to map the broker certificate directory into the container. We're going to set the container onto the right network. And then when you run that, you should see that once again, you're connected and everything is running. So we have replicated the working configuration, but none of the configuration is now locked inside the container. So in step 6, we can go and update the container in the Docker Hub repository. So make sure that you've pushed all the changes up into GitHub, and then on a command line in the project directory where the Docker file is, you're going to run the docker buildx command. Just as a note, make sure that your Docker builder is running. If you've taken a break between this tutorial and the previous one, you may have to go and use inspect with the bootstrap option to start the builder. And then you can stop and remove all the Node-RED containers. Do a Docker pull to make sure that you've actually got the latest version of your Docker image from the Docker Hub repository. And now you can run the container. We can use the same environment file, but this time we're going to pass in the fully qualified path so you can run this command from any directory. And now you should see that you have, once again, a fully working environment, and you can use the Docker log option if you want to check that it's all running. So here we go. The three tutorials have shown you how to integrate GitHub with Node-RED, how to package an application into a container, and finally, how to update that application so all of the configuration comes from the environment. And this container is now suitable for deploying in an environment like Kubernetes or OpenShift. So I hope you enjoyed these tutorials and found them valuable.